first met Paul when I moved to LA more than 10 years ago. I remember I moved in, I bought a bookcase from like Target, and I was hammering it together. I didn't realize how late it was.
And he was making so much noise, I had to go downstairs and ask him to please could you not put your furniture together right now? I have a crew sleeping on my floor. We were making a short film.
And I thought, oh great, so first guy I met and he hates me, but turned out not so much.
Never liked Austin, don't trust the guy.
Well, he does hate me. But he had a need for a composer, so he was able to get past that. And somehow for 10 years, that's the stalemate we've been in.
We've done 3 features together. We started with Grace, and then we did Dark Summer, and now we've done Bullethead. The movie on the surface about 3 criminals, you know, professional criminals that pull a heist, they fuck it up, and they end up stuck in a warehouse with a very angry dog.
But Paul's movies are never about what they're about. You know, the poster image and the genre you find it on Netflix or whatever is never fully representative of the film. There's always a lot of layers.
What it really is sort of a study of the similarities between a career criminal and a fighting dog. So it's kind of an exploration of the phenomenon of conditioning. You know, is it ever too late to overcome your conditioning? And can you change and can you grow? And can you ever teach an old dog new tricks?
The subtext that I was particularly interested in was all the characters in this film have been kind of molded through life circumstance, totally outside of their control, to be in this situation. And so I thought they are kind of victims of their circumstance, but they all don't really think of themselves as victims either. They're just trying to make their way. And one of the things that I love about working with Paul is that we both want to aggressively use the score to express those kind of subtext layers. We are going into this film with a certain expectation of watching 3 guys fight this vicious dog. And there was something very Roman Colosseum or Circus Maximus feeling about that to me. So I went into a parking garage with some trumpet players and a mobile recording rig and wrote a bunch of fanfares out and said, let's just record these. And we captured them the way they echoed through this beautiful giant space. There's a theatricality to hearing these trumpet fanfares, like, we're now going to perform for you. And there was something about this film that gave me that feeling. And I thought it's interesting to add to these scenes that level of theatricality. And so it's often distorted in a way so where it's mainly just adding a kind of vicious energy.
One of the things that we kept coming back to was this notion of, you know, almost building a sort of a cathedral-esque environment. There was some spirit to what was happening here. It is sort of a spiritual journey for Stacy, for the other guys as well. That was something that Austin wanted to reflect in the score, and he had a really interesting approach.
I started thinking about musical genres and tropes and things like that that evoke that feeling of not just redemption, but of spirituality in a kind of more general sense. And the first thing that came to mind was a gospel hymn. And what I found very appealing about that was that it spoke directly to the subtext of the film while being a pretty atypical thing to attach to a film like this.
Long I've traveled, long I've struggled, strong my grip upon my sword and my shield.
We had to be careful because it was easy to overdo. And so it's sort of tucked away throughout the film, hidden along the edges of the frame, until kind of the climax where you finally really hear it. And then we actually hear it in earnest over the end credits.
One of the things Austin has always been so good at is finding the gold in a sort of a limited, limited budget and sort of embracing the constraints.
The simplest element to the score is that it's very savage. Even though there's a lot to this film, it is functionally a thriller. And so we definitely needed something that had the power, had the energy. And because of the kind of primal struggle of these guys and this dog, I thought we have to have just kind of a raw percussion kind of energy, a raw, almost caveman sensibility to it.
talked a lot over the years about understanding what our limitations will be up front, leaning into them and saying, okay, great, well, how do we exploit those? And all sorts of workarounds lead to these just really, you know, terrific things that you might not otherwise have done if you had an unlimited amount of time and money.
It's not every day that you get to do a film where you are recording trumpets in garages and savage percussion and writing original hymn tunes and a bunch of weird custom electronics and all of that. And then at the end of the day, you get to say, this is a film that's actually got a weird kind of loving undertone to it. It's a film about people just trying to do the right thing. Those sorts of strange puzzles that all of those elements somehow equal one film, I live for that. And I just feel really lucky to be a part of it.
I don't like that at all. Don't use any of that.